when you're at a places like this where the stakes are high, there's a lot of big feelings. There's rage. There's feelings of injustice. There's misinformation. There's a lot of division. And I'm not just talking here at the RNC. It's at the DNC. It's everywhere where you get a collective mass of people. And so the stakes are higher. The emotions are higher. Not everyone has the same mechanism for communication. People are getting triggered left and right. And it's easy to let that, the negativity, start to sink into your cells. And it can become fatiguing, overwhelming. And it can force us to become reactive instantaneously when it's not even in our nature.
For me, what it's helped is for me to look within myself and see what's going on inside. Like when I react to something emotionally, what happened there? What, you know, what's transpiring inside my body? What's happening with my emotions? What's happening with my thoughts? So now I'm better able, not completely able, but I'm better able to observe those things. Instead of reacting to things with emotion, I can call and I can act. I can choose, I can respond.
Politics has a lot of intensity in them, and yoga helps reduce some of that intensity. I think most people agree, even with no medical experience, that if you're calmer, you're able to think better. And if you're thinking better, no matter what it is, you can make better decisions. And in politics, good decisions and thinking clearly, I think, is very important.
We need to breathe. We need to be able to take a moment, look around at our environment, and tap into what's important. If my job is here as a reporter, as a delegate, as a yoga teacher, to be able to support that understanding that I'm going to do my job well.